This lecture is mainly focusing the problem related to periodicity. Okay. And we will do some problems and we will check whether the signal is periodic. And if it is periodic, we will find the fundamental period. Okay. And the formula related to the periodicity and the concept definition and all we discussed in the previous lecture. And now we will do the problems. Okay. So here you can see that we need to find out we need to check the signal x of t is equal to cos t plus pi by 4, whether it is a periodic signal. If a signal is periodic, then determines fundamental period. Okay. We already discussed that any signal of the form x of t is equal to a sine omega t plus theta is a periodic signal, or all the continuous time sinusoidal signals are periodic with period. Fundamental period T0 is equal to 2 pi by omega. So we already derived this particular formula, and now we can find the fundamental period of this particular signal. And if you compare with the equation, here you can see the amplitude is 1, and the fundamental period is only depends on the omega. Okay. So if you compare with this particular equation, in this case omega is equal to 1. Okay, so the fundamental period T0 is equal to 2 pi by omega. So we can substitute that, so we'll get 2 pi by 1. So the fundamental period of this particular signal is 2 pi second. Here only asked fundamental period, but we can also find out the fundamental frequency, which is given by 1 by T0, or you can say that 1 by 2 pi hertz. Similarly, you can also find out the angular frequency also. Angular frequency is 2 pi f0. So 2 pi into 1 by 2 pi. So that much radians per second. So the unit of angular frequency is radians per second. So you will get 1 radians per second. The question is only asked fundamental period, but we can also find out the fundamental frequency and the angular frequency. So f omega 0 is known as the angular frequency. So next one, in this particular question, x of t is given by sine 2 pi by 3 into t. Again, it's a continuous time signal, continuous time sinusoidal signal. So it is a periodic signal. So periodic signal, and the fundamental period of the signal is T0 is 2 pi by omega. And if you compare with the standard equation, here omega is equal to 2 pi by 3. Okay, so this is omega actually. Okay, if we compare with the standard equation, so we need to find out T0, which is given by 2 pi divided by omega. So omega is 2 pi by 2 pi by 3. So you will get 3 seconds. So this is the fundamental period, and we can also find out the fundamental frequency, which is 1 by T0, which is equal to 1 by 3 hertz. And we can also calculate the angular frequency omega 0, which is 2 pi f0. So 2 pi into 1 by 3. That much radians per second. So if you look at this particular quantity omega 0, you can directly calculate the omega 0 from the equation itself, so which is 2 pi by 3. So that much radians per second. So now we'll discuss another type of problem, which is very important. Before going to the problem, we will discuss some points related to this question. Here you can see that a cos pi by 3 t is a sinusoidal signal plus sine pi by 4 t. So this is not individual signal, it's actually sum of two signals. For example, you can assume that this is signal x1 of t and this is another signal x2 of t. These two signals are continuous time signal, so individually they are periodic because it's a sinusoidal signal. So x1 of t is periodic because it's a continuous time sinusoidal signal. so they are periodic. But here the signals are given as a sum of two signals. So x of t as a signal, which is sum of x1 of t and x2 of t. So in such cases, we need to remember this particular property. That is a sum of two continuous time. It's very important as a continuous time signal. This rule is valid only for a continuous time signal. Okay, continuous time periodic signal. The sum of two continuous time periodic signal is periodic only if, okay, only if the ratio of their respective periods can be expressed as a rational number. And if it satisfies that particular condition, then the fundamental period is simply the LCM of two. Okay. In this particular example, if x1 of t be the one signal and the fundamental period is t1, and x2 be the other signal and that is t2, the fundamental period of the next signal, then the sum of these two signals, that is x1 of t plus x2 of t, is periodic only if t1 by t2 is a rational number. Rash means t by t1 by t2 can be written as p by q form, where p and q are integers. Okay, that's the meaning of rational, and q not equal to zero. So that's the meaning. So the p and q should not contain any terms like pi, root 2, etc. Okay, then it becomes irrational. A quick trick to check whether the signal is rational or rational: after finding the ratio t1 by t2, check whether it contain any pi, root 2 terms, then it becomes irrational. So if the signal is rational, or if this particular ratio t1 by t2 is rational, then the fundamental period is simply, we can find out LCM of t1 t2. Okay, so that's the rule. So this is very important, and this rule is valid only for a continuous time periodic signal. Okay, when it comes to discrete time signal, the rule is different. So that's why it's very important, it's a continuous time periodic signal. So the two signals are individually periodic, but the sum may not be periodic always. Okay, so we can approach this particular question. So the first signal x1 of t is cos pi by 3t. So the fundamental period of this particular signal, you can find out 2 pi by omega, which is equal to 2 pi by 2 pi by 3, which is equal to 3 seconds. Similarly, the signal x2 of t can be written as sine pi by 4t, and from this you can calculate t2, which is equal to 2 pi by omega. And here omega is equal to pi by 4, which is equal to 8 actually. Okay, 8 seconds. Now we need to find out the ratio t1 by t2. Okay, so now we need to find out whether the signal x of t is periodic or not. So this is actually the periodic city check. Okay, we need to find t1 by t2. So that is here it is 3 and here it is 8. So 3 by 8. So 3 by 8 means 3 and 8 are integers. So we can write it is in the p by q form. So we can call it as a rational. If it is rational, then we can say that the signal x of t is periodic. So one part is over. The given signal, the sum of two signals, is a periodic signal. Now we need to find the period of this particular signal, fundamental period of the signal x0. So now we need to find the fundamental period of the signal x of t, which is equal to t0, which is the LCM of 3 and 8, t1 and t2. So we will get 24. So 24 seconds will be the fundamental period of the signal x of t. Okay, And this we can also find out in another method. That is the ratio we are getting is T1 by T2 is 3 by A. And if you simply cross multiply this, you will get T1 into 8, okay, or T2 into 3. Okay. So T2 into 3. So in this way also you can find out the fundamental period. So this cross multiplication will result into the fundamental period. So we know that T1 is 3. So 3 into A, you'll get 24 seconds. Or you can find out T2 is 8. So 8 into 3, again 24 seconds. So either you can use the formula LCM of the two, or you can cross multiply the two signals, this particular equation, T1 by T2 ratio in the simplified form. And if you cross multiply, you will get the fundamental period. So this is a typical problem when the given question contain two parts, the sum of two signals. Okay. Now we'll discuss a similar question. Again, it's a continuous time signal. So when the continuous time periodic signal are given, then it's periodic only if the ratio of the respective period is a rational number. Okay, now we need to identify that the signal x1 of t, which is equal to cos t, and the fundamental period of this signal x1 of t can be written as 2 pi by omega. So here omega is equal to 1, so you'll get 2 pi seconds. Similarly, if you write the second signal, that is x2 of t, which is equal to sine root 2 t. So from this you can calculate T2, which is 2 pi by omega. So in place of omega, it is root 2. So we can write root 2. So this 2 pi by root 2 seconds. So we know that T1 and T2 are periodic because they are continuous time sinusoidal signal. So X1 of T is a periodic signal. X2 of T, again a periodic signal. But we need to verify that whether X of T is a periodic or not. So we need to check whether x of t is periodic or not. Okay. So to check that, we need to find the ratio T1 by T2. And if you find T1 by T2, it's 2 pi by T2 is 2 pi by root 2. So you will get root 2, which is root 2 by 1. If you look at this particular equation, which is not equal to p by q form, because p and q are not integers, root 2 we cannot write in the form of integers. Okay, so this is not rational, so we can call it as a irrational number. Irrational. So this given signal x of t is a non-periodic signal. Non-periodic signal, or we can say that it's an aperiodic signal. So we cannot find out the fundamental period. So it's very important. The signal x1 of t is periodic, x2 of t is also periodic, but the sum of these two signals is not periodic because we cannot find the ratio as a rational number. We are getting as an irrational number. We cannot write in the p by q form, so because there is a term root 2. Okay. So now we'll discuss another question. Again, in this particular question, it is given x of t is equal to sine square of t. It is very important because we derived one equation, x of t is equal to a sine omega t. If the signal is of the form x of t is equal to a sine omega t plus theta, then the fundamental period is equal to t0 is equal to 2 pi by omega. But here it is given sine square. So we cannot directly apply this particular formula. So we need to convert this into a power one equation. Okay. So the sine square t is actually sine t into sine t. The product form we cannot apply. Sum, there is a rule. And if it is in the form a sine omega t, we can apply. So we need to change it using the sum formula. So by using this particular relation, sine square theta is equal to 1 minus cos 2 theta by 2. So half angle formula. So this formula is very useful when you do the problem. So please remember these two terms. Sine square theta is 1 minus cos 2 theta by 2, and cos square theta is 1 plus cos 2 theta by 2. So by applying this particular formula, you can write it becomes 1 minus cos, in place of theta it is t, so you need to write 2t divided by 2. So it becomes 1 by 2 minus cos 2t by 2. And if you look at this particular equation, it's actually sum of two signals. And now we can analyze this particular signal. Here you can see that the first part is actually a DC component because there is no t term. So if you observe the signal x1 of t, okay, and if you plot the signal x1 of t, it will be like this. This is x1 of t, and it is 1 by 2. This is 0, and this is amplitude 0.1 by 2. Irrespective of the t, the function value is always 1 by 2. Means you are getting a constant signal. Okay, from minus infinity to plus infinity, the function magnitude is half. Now we are adding or subtracting a signal called cos 2t by 2. Means if you add or subtract a signal by using a DC means, it's simply a clamping operation. So when you add or subtract with a constant value, the periodicity of the signal will not change. Okay, so there is no importance for this amplitude. Actually, this is a cos signal. Okay, so it's a cosine waveform. It'll be cos t or cos 2t. And if you add or subtract the signal with another signal, another DC signal, the periodicity will not change because this is the time period of this particular signal. And the time period will be remain same if you add these two signals. And if you add or subtract the signal, only the DC point is shifting, okay, from zero to a higher value, a lower value. Okay, so make sure that when there is a DC component, you simply omit that particular portion and find the fundamental period of the other part. So that is x2 of t, you can simply calculate. So x2 of t is cos 2t. Similarly, there is no significance for this amplitude because in the final equation, if you consider the standard equation, there is no importance for this A. It's simply T0. You can find out the fundamental frequency is 2 pi by omega. And omega is 2, so you'll get pi. So the fundamental period of the given signal is pi second. Also, you can calculate the fundamental frequency is 1 by pi hertz. And the angular frequency is 2 pi by 2 pi f0, or you can write 2 pi into 1 pi pi, which is equal to 2 radians per second. Okay. Now we'll do a problem which is an exponential signal, complex exponential signal. For the complex exponential signal, again, the formula is same. So only thing we need to find out the omega time. So if you compare with the standard equation, e raised to j omega t plus theta, the final equation, it's a j omega t plus theta. The fundamental period is simply 2 pi by omega. Okay. So from this particular question here, omega is equal to pi by 2. So the fundamental period T0 is 2 pi by omega, which is given by 2 pi by pi by 2. Okay, so you'll get 4 seconds. So the fundamental frequency is 1 by 4 hertz, and the angular frequency is 2 pi f0, which is equal to 2 pi by 4, which is equal to pi by 2 radians per second. Or you can directly calculate from this particular point, that is omega zero actually. Okay. Now we can do the problem related to discrete time signal. So previously we discussed all the continuous time signal. Now we can discuss discrete time signal. So again, when it is a discrete time signal, we cannot say that it's always periodic. Discrete time sinusoidal signals are periodic only, it satisfies some conditions. So we can just verify that. Check that if there is a signal a sine omega n plus theta of the form, then the fundamental period you can write n0 is m to pi by omega, but there is a condition this n0 by m should be a rational number. Okay, it should satisfy this condition, then only or n0 should be an integer. Okay, then only that signal is periodic. So, but in the case of continuous time signal, all the sinusoidal signals are periodic. But in the case of discrete time signal, there is a question mark. Okay, sometimes it's periodic, and sometimes it's not periodic. So we need to verify that also. So for that, we need to find out n zero. So first, omega is equal to 1/4, and n zero, the fundamental period of the discrete time signal, you can write as 2 pi m. By omega, so there's a term called m for the smallest value of m. N0 should be an integer, so we can verify that. So 2 pi m by omega is 1/4, so you'll get 8 pi into m. Okay, so from this, you can see that N0 by m is 8 pi, which is not a rational number. Okay, this is an irrational number. So the given signal is that is x of n is non-periodic signal, or we can say it's an aperiodic signal, or we can say in another way, that is n0 is given by 8 pi by m. If you substitute the values of m is equal to 1, it becomes 8 pi. If m is equal to 2, it becomes 16 pi. And similarly, if you try any value for m, it will not be an integer. So n0 cannot be an integer. So it is not periodic. Okay, in two ways you can conclude. Either you can find n0 by its rational number, or you can check different values of m. If for the smallest value of m for which n0 becomes an integer. So in this particular case, it's not possible because there is a term called pi. So we can try another problem. Here you can see that again a discrete time signal. This signal is x1 of n, and assume that this is another signal x2 of n. It's actually given as a sum of two discrete time sequences. It's very important, this is discrete time sequence. So there's a condition that if sum of two discrete time periodic sequence, previously we discussed the continuous time periodicity condition, now we are discussing discrete time periodicity condition. If two periodic sequence, that is x1, if x1 of n is periodic and x2 of n is periodic, then the resultant sum is always periodic. But in the case of continuous time signal, this is not true. In the case of continuous time signal, there is a condition that the ratio T1 by T2 is a rational number. Then only it is periodic. But here, there is no such condition because if x1 of n is periodic means n1 is an integer. Again, x2 of n is periodic means n2 is an integer. Then definitely n1 by n2 will give you a rational ratio. So only thing, we need to verify that the individually they are periodic or not. So here x1 of n is cos pi by 3n. So from this, n1 is equal to 2 pi by omega, which is equal to 2 pi by 5 by 3. So 6 seconds. So n2 is 2 pi by omega, because x2 of n is equal to sine pi by 4 n. So it becomes 2 pi by 5 by 4. So you will get 8. Okay. Now we need to so this n1 is an integer and n2 is also an integer, so definitely the sum will be a periodic signal. So the given signal x of n is periodic, or you can verify that n1 by n2 will be again 6 by 8, which is equal to 3 by 4, which is always periodic. Okay, it's a rational number, so it is periodic. There is no need to evaluate this particular condition, because in the case of discrete time signals, if individually they are periodic, then the sum is always periodic, provided that the signal is individually periodic. Now we need to find the fundamental period. So fundamental period n0 is simply the LCM of n1 and n2. So here n1 and n2 is so we need to find LCM of 6 and 8, which is 24. Or you can use the same concept here, n1 by n2, which is a simplified form, is 3 by 4. So if you cross multiply this, you will get n1 into 4, or you can say n2 into 3. This is also results in the fundamental period n0. So n1 is 6, so 6 into 4, which is equal to 24. And again n2 is 8, so 8 into 3, again 24. Okay, so this is the fundamental period of the discrete time sequence, which is given as a sum of two signals. Now we can discuss another question. Here the signal is given as cos square pi by 8n. Again, it's a discrete time signal, so we need to check the periodicity first, because we cannot say that signal is periodic. But another problem that here it is given us as cos square, so we need to apply this formula and we need to make the equation in the normal form. So it becomes 1 by 2 plus cos 2 theta, so it becomes 2 pi by 8n, okay, in the whole divided by 2. So if you simplify, you will get 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 cos pi by 4n. So already we discussed that this is the DC component, so simply shift, it's a discrete time sequence. So if you consider the first signal as x1 of n, this n, and 0, 1, 2, here it is minus 1, minus 2, etc. And the discrete time signal, and the signal magnitude is 1 by 2 always. And if you add this 1 by 2 with a cos pi by fn, it will not change the periodicity of the signal. So we can simply find the periodicity of the signal x2 of n, which is 1 by 2 cos pi by 4. And if you compare with the standard equation, this n0 is equal to 2 pi by omega, 2 pi m by omega, which is equal to 2 pi by 2 pi by 4, not 2 pi, it's pi by 4, so you'll get 8. So the fundamental period of the discrete time sequence, cos square pi by 8n is 8.